Hello and welcome to my channel. My name is Paps, your partner in creating the life you design and deserve. I'm a life coach, I'm a psychologist, and I'm a mentor. And today is a Q&A day. We're going to answer a few questions that you've been sending to me, and please keep the questions coming so that I can keep on interacting and just seeing what you need, and then we'll be able to converse about it. And so someone is asking here, Paps, my mother-in-law doesn't like me. I've done everything and she sees nothing good in me for 9 years. I honor her, I do my best for her, I visit her, but she just doesn't like me, and sometimes it bothers me. And I really feel for you, Agnes, and one of the things I will tell you is that it's valid. And one of the things I would encourage you, please grieve, allow yourself to feel the loss. Every young girl, when you're planning to get married, we always hope that we will be the most favorite thing for our mother-in-laws. And so when it doesn't happen, 9 years you've been hoping every day, from the first time probably she met you and she was like, not this one, you should get a better wife. And then you stuck on 9 years on. And first of all, congratulations, you're just that wife material kind of a girl. And the other thing I will also encourage you is to still keep your boundaries. Keep your boundaries. Don't lose yourself in the process of trying to please her and to go out of your way and to lose yourself. Because one of the things, there's nothing you can do to make her like you. Just do your best. Keep your boundaries. Don't allow her to violate you and to just get into your space in an unhealthy way. Keep your boundaries firm. And the other thing that will also encourage you, keep on adjusting your expectations. You know, what did you expect she would do for you? Who else can do it for you? Adjust your expectations so that you can be happy, because you owe yourself happiness. Show up in those spaces and bring your happiness along. Don't go and look for happiness in those places and then you get disappointed and it's a roller coaster over and over again. And of course, the other thing that will also encourage you, that you don't have it with her, but you still have many other people who love you and who like you and people who appreciate you. And so it's important to also focus on many other things that are working in your life besides your mother-in-law. And then I think keep on loving her and praying for her and just hoping that one day she'll be able to see the beauty you are even in her son's life. I hope that responds to you. And the other question that I want to respond to you today, how do I know, perhaps, how do I know what God has called me to do or what God has created me to do? And how do I actualize it in me? And I meet so many people as a purpose clarity coach as well, who want to just know, what has God called me to do? Where do I start? Do I even know it? And of course, one of the things I always encourage us is that look above. You're first of all here for God. You're here for God. Keep on listening and tuning in and just leaning in to be able to know what is His will and purpose for your life. And then I think, look within, what has He invested in you? And one of the things we do in our program is something called Shape Assessment. We just take you through 5 things that can actually help you start out your journey to just see what you are gifted in, what you are good at, you know, and what actually rolls out for you. Yeah, and thank you for watching. Please subscribe. Send this link to your friends to subscribe as well, and so that you can keep it here for more exciting content that is coming out. My name is Paps, your partner in creating the life you design. Ciao.